a reflection call. It's calling SUSI inside a SUSI script. That means one random answer, one of these colors, is then part of the result, which is then also stored to the variable. And if you ask the same question again, the variable accepts and it answers my favorite color is, and it responds with the same color. That means SUSI is able to have a random answer, but then remember the random answer, just in one line, okay?
So this is another example of JavaScript. And computation with JavaScript. And then what I already showed you, the example. So all the constructions. You can also do a decision tree with all these variables. So if you want to do a dialogue and you want to switch between positions in the dialogue, you can remember that you have been inside the dialogue position if you write a variable and make a decision over the position of the variable. So you can make a complete conversation flow with all this setup of the variables. Okay? So SUSI is able to make a kind of interview. It can ask you where do you live, what's your age, and what you want, and so on. And if variables are set or not, it can be a decision of an answer like, if it's not set how old you are, it will answer at some time what's your age. So what do you need to start programming? So the easiest environment is a so-called SUSI Dream. And the SUSI Dream is nothing else than an Etherpad. So do you know what an Etherpad is? Anyone has heard Etherpad? So an Etherpad is Etherpad is a web page which is empty and where you can put in anything. So if you go to Dream SUSI.AI, you get this, and then you can name an Etherpad. We take an Etherpad, we call it workshop. Okay? And you can take the same, you can go to the same place. Open Dream SUSI.AI. And put in the word workshop. And then you get the same thing as I have here. Okay? So let's open a chat. Now we can tell SUSI to use that SUSI Dream as an input for a chat. So on the right side I have my SUSI Dream, and on the left side I have chat window. I can say tell the chat that it should dream about my SUSI Dream. And I just say Dream Workshop. That means it's now using the right side as the skill input. And so we can start developing a skill. So if I say workshop, the answer should be this workshop is about SUSI. Okay, very easy. And we can start writing something. Like you can try to create. Skill like this. So. not what I expected. Tried to open the SUSI Dream?
Yeah.
Have you tried something? Because everything which you put in, I would see here. Questions? Server is really under load and very, very slow. It's a really bad demonstration situation because nothing is working. Really. And not even the build script is working in a fast way or is doing anything at all. Server which is not running anything else because everything I killed everything. So this is another example where we get information from an external API. In this case, take it from this location. So this gives us recipes for any meal description, and there is a results object with some object like title, and link, ingredients. So we could also change this in ingredients from. Our ingredients are already here. if we want to use any kind of external API, we have to look up for the JSON object that's imported in a dynamic web page. So if you,
for example, want to get a skill that takes information from a lottery or from lottery result or news or a sports page, then you can go into a debug mode and see if the information is taken just outside from some debug information. So I don't have a very good example right now. Maybe we can take weather report for the weather and look into the debugger and hope that there is some. And there's some information which I can use for weather. So there you see there's a lot of JSON objects returned from outside. And not really something I can use. Yes?
To how do you influence the response? Because like you know you said you pass the entity and they propose to you the subversion based model. But I asked about preparing spaghetti and it tells me I'd rather not say. So how do you
I'd rather not say means
it doesn't
recognize your question. So at this skill is only used because I switched on the SUSI Dream for it. So it's called the SUSI Dream. And it can only access this thing. So what do you want to change? So what did you ask SUSI?
I actually typed the same question, the same. Like prepare spaghetti, so I follow the same.
And you have
but I didn't get the same.
And you used a SUSI Dream for this? Okay, you're in the chat.
Yeah.
But before you can use this, you have to say Dream Workshop. Because then it's telling SUSI that it's supposed to use this. Because this dream is called Workshop. It's the Workshop Dream. So Dream is the development zone for SUSI skills. You put in Dream Workshop.
Yeah, now I get the same results.
Now you get the same results. Okay. So what would if you have a suggestion, what kind of external information you want to access, then just give me your ideas. What kind of external information? So we have a lot of categories, food and drink, and problem solving. I don't know what it all does. So this is running in JavaScript. So what kind of skill would you like to create if you would start creating a skill?
Can I ask you this?
Access the API by an instance skill. So the instance skill means you can pass the skill as part of the post request. That's also possible. Try to find another example where you can get the API. Maybe there's another Singapore in the northern hemisphere.
It would be nice.
So okay, this looks interesting. There's a lot of data in JSON objects out there. You can take it from these dynamic web pages, but it's not always easy to find them. So I opened up the Singapore forecasts API. So I can say Singapore weather, that should also work with Singapore. So it gives me this part here in the JSON object. Okay, because in the JSON path is forecasts, and then the first element detailed forecast, first part detailed, and then reports, and then I get an array where the first object has the name enhanced weather description, and that's the name I put in here. Right? So I cannot look up any city, but I can get this particular information. So usually you should have an API which accepts a query word, and you can use that query word. Okay. So most skills you have are this kind of pattern matching type, and so you can put in some information. And you could store this. The word breeze. All right. So there's not so much magic, and the biggest point in this environment is that the skill content management system, and because we are making development of skills so easy, it should. We are hoping that it gets an effect like Wikipedia. Wikipedia was a disruptive moment in web development, because before the Wikipedia, people had to learn HTML to do publishment. So they addressed people who had knowledge and want to put somewhere their knowledge, but they shouldn't learn HTML. So the Wikipedia enabled them to put down their knowledge in some place, because it was easy to write them down. And we want to do the same with skills. We want to make it easy to write them down. So we don't have to get an account at AWS. You don't have to do programming. And it's easy to edit them online and change them online. The only thing which I'm really sorry that it's not working is the preview. The preview of a skill is not working right now. So I wanted to make a skill about copy, which can explain what kind of copy that is. So let's call it language is, right. Let's start from the beginning. Working. That's too bad. Let's save this. Yeah, I need an image. change, but this is a copy. Let's steal the picture. Way to create a skill would be to use a SUSI dream and then copy what you created in the dream here until the preview is fixed, which would take just some days.
It's possible to call SUSI skills using the SUSI API, right?
You can call the SUSI API directly. Or what do you mean?
Yeah, it's how would you call it?
So
that you can pull a skill so you don't have to talk to it.
Something is not working right now. It's not doing the storage as well. It's really bad. Hope I can fix this. I don't know why it's not working right now. I have to do debugging. fix this bug. I can't fix this now, this is too complex. So I will find it out. I don't know what happens here. Maybe this is not the best time you can waste if I'm doing debugging and you're watching me debugging a code which should work. So what can I do to enable you to otherwise use this?
Okay, so do you know more about the SUSI API?
Yes, sure.
Is it what? Is it the SUSI API? I'm more interested in SUSI API, you can call skills, right? The SUSI API. As in, how will you do it?
Let's repeat.
As in, you can call SUSI skills through the SUSI API, right?
Yeah.
All you have to do is just import it through. Just use it through the
API. Yeah, for testing, yes.
For testing.
But, usually, you either have skill in a skill repository, or you have a private skill, or there is a SUSI team, or you have an instant skill. The instant skill is a skill text which you pass to the call of the SUSI API. Okay? So,
let me see. That's probably what you want. You pass the skill in the instant object.
Instant object.
Yeah. For example, here. first. So we have a query, it's called, can you see this? Is this visible?
Yeah.
So what you ask SUSI is test. You have an instant object where you have test as the query part, and then I have / n as the return, and then okay as the answer. And that's what happens here. You have an action, and it says it's an answer type, and the phrase is okay. So you can pass the full skill in that object, and you can pass it also as a post in a post request. So post for really large requests, the post request would be more appropriate. I'm not passing this in a GET request.
So you could use a post request also, right? That's the top one. So you can use a GET request or a post request for
the you can GET or post.
I
the both is going in. Something is broken, which was working all the time. So, but if you can use the instant skill, then and that was the only thing you had been searching for, then that's the solution for you or what you're looking for. I will try to fix this. Louder, please.
I
don't still understand.
I roughly get like one to be AI and one to be a chatbot.
want to have a private chatbot,
personal chatbot,
then
I go to skills. Not skills. Bot builder. You can create a bot, and then you have the same interface, and. Change the color, set some configurations, and I have an error. So just 2 hours ago I've seen a presentation of a developer where it was working, but that's the process. So we have you have configured a bot. And then you can plug in this as an HTML in your web page. Yeah, that's the idea. You get an HTML script. Then you get an error. Already exists, which is strange. So I have the copy expert here. It's not working. I can't show it to you, not right now, it's not working.
Yeah.
That's too bad.
I mean,
You can install your own SUSI version. That means I could use it in a chat.
Okay. See where it was.
Stop dreaming. Poopy. Black coffee with condensed milk. Yes.
Yes. Finally.
Why? Why didn't it work before? All right. We create finally.
Okay.
After 2.5 hours, we created a skill.
Yeah, I know. We need to have patience to wait.
All right. So what else? What kind of copy we have? Copy ice? No, we don't have copy ice. Why don't we have copy ice? Copy. What is it called correctly? So let's go to food and drink. We have the copy expert. Now we should be able to edit this. Also. Okay, copy peng, copy o, sweet black coffee with ice, copy o peng. Yeah, why a peng is with ice? Why? So, if I call it, no, I cannot say copy ice because then it's not something to say. Or is it called copy with ice? Yesterday I ordered a copy ice. I got one.
Oh.
It was great.
That's
interesting. So if there is a copy or peng, why there isn't there a copy peng? Maybe this is a mistake. It shouldn't be copy kosong peng.
Kopi kosong peng is coffee unsweetened ice. Yeah.
Unsweetened?
Yes.
And what is a kopi peng?
Peng means ice. And kosong means no sugar.
And that means a kopi peng is a sweetened.
Kopi peng isn't sweetened, yes.
Ah, here is kopi peng. I created a copy expert without being an expert. Now I go to chat. Copy ping. Okay, that's working. Then I can say explain. And explain means it shows me where the definition of this skill is, and it's not yet pushed to GitHub, therefore I cannot access it, but it's supposed to be pushed to GitHub. But usually if you click on a skill, you get the skill location in GitHub. And you can also, if you have a GitHub account, you can edit it there, but you don't have write, only I have write.
You don't have
the right
access.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I still wonder why this didn't work. What was wrong? I'm now running with my own internet.
Oh.
I don't know if this is a difference. It's different with my differing.
Yeah. But how many?
How many. How much it takes?
How much?
It's just using the API access that very, very few.
I mean,
it's just doing this. So it's just some JSON. Expert is there, but it's not pushed yet, and it's not in Git status. Why isn't it in Git status? It should be recognized, shouldn't it? Find out what's wrong with this Git repository. All right. So I think that's it. If you don't have questions, any questions?